So let's take a look now at the purpose of this lab. We're going to be working within PyProcessBook, this PyProcessBook modeler here. And what we'd like to do is we're going to be connecting to a specific AF database and then dragging and dropping the elements from this AF database onto a ProcessBook display. You'll notice there's an AF browser that we can use for that in ProcessBook. So we'll use AF to help us build the display. We'll assign specific tank symbols to certain element templates in AF to make it easier to do our work. And then also, we're going to be taking some attributes that you'll find in AF and presenting them on the display itself. Now here's the grand finale. Here's what you're going to be building. As you can see, it's a PyProcessBook display. And this ProcessBook display makes use of these elements that you see right here. These are AF elements. We're dragging these elements out onto this display here and then making use of AF's capabilities to drag things like these attributes. So for example, if I drill down through here, you can see selecting these elements here in the AF browser here is going to have its analog on the display. So these are basically the elements represented graphically, the elements in AF represented graphically. And there's some nice advantages to doing this. For example, you can drag things from here and drop them over onto this so that we can see we've now associated these different attributes with that image. Now, I should mention now that the work we're doing today is really kind of assuming that you've got an AF database with these following elements, and those elements have specific attributes. Well, that's no problem in the case of the learning lab because we've configured AF to have those elements. If you look at the solution here, this is an XML file that's basically, it's the configuration file that you can use to build that AF database. So if you need to use that for testing purposes on your own machine, you'll find that file right here. So that's the situation. We basically would like to take advantage of the developments we've done in AF inside PyProcessBook, and that's what this lab is all about. So I'm going to switch over to a copy of ProcessBook, and you'll notice that within the View menu, when you do install the add-in to ProcessBook that supports Analysis Framework, you have the ability to add these different analysis framework oriented windows. So there's a property window and there is a browser window. Now that I've added this, I can go ahead and connect to a database. Again, assume you already have a database that you've configured. In this case, we do assume that. We're going to use this tank farm. And as you can see, this is now showing me through analysis framework components here, the windows, the different elements and also the element templates for that particular database. At the risk of belaboring the obvious, let me point out the relationship between these two windows here. When I choose elements, these are the elements in my tank farm database. Down here, the properties that show up are going to be those that correspond to what I've selected. This tank ERY623 has the following sets of attributes. If I switch to a different tank, I see a different set of attributes. So for example, this particular tank is 10 meters in diameter, height of 8 meters. The one above it is 15 meters by 20 meters. And here's all the other things that are associated with this, the level, the temperature, etc. These different attributes are going to have different data references. Some of them are PyPoint references, like we've seen before. Some are formulas and some are table lookups. In case it wasn't obvious before, I'd like to demonstrate how the objects that you see listed in the elements in this browser, the AF browser window, they're the same objects that you'll find on the screen typically. So for example, here is my my Delta Rule model, and if I double click on Tank A, you'll notice I'm simply selecting Tank A on the display. And of course what we see is now we see the attributes of Tank A. And if I do have a model that let's say I've made some additions to the model in the AF browser, but I haven't done this in ProcessBook yet, since this element exists in the AF browser, and also since there are some things associated with it, like for example this graphic right here is associated with that element, then I can just drag this and drop it in place, and it actually creates the graphic display, or on the graphic display, the representation of that. In addition to dragging the elements, you can also drag attributes. Like for example, I'll go to Tank A. Here are the attributes of Tank A, and the thing that we're doing in this particular calculation is we're doing a delta calculation. Actually, I can actually drag that over here and drop it and associate that now with that object so that it follows it around. As you can see, it's just displaying in a value. It's displaying that that attribute. So again, I can choose Tank A, and any of these things, diameter, level, etc., I can drag and I can put that in place and then associate that with the what's on the screen. And notice in the case of this delta, it's currently measured in liters per second, but I can actually go in to the definition for this object. I'll double click on this and bring up the value definition, and I can specify a different unit of measure. I'll go into AF, let's say instead of liters per second, we're going to go with US gallons per minute. As you can see, because the AF has been defined to no units of measures in this case, this is coming back with the proper conversion, and it's showing me the right unit of measure in the legend there. ProcessBook has been designed to work with the elements that you build in analysis framework. Namely, for example, in run mode, this element attribute, level, this is Tank A, the level attribute. If you remember, that was a data reference to a PI tag. Let me show you that. Here's level, and it is a reference to that tag. But it really doesn't matter what that is. It could be a lookup, or it could be getting data from a calculation, a formula. It doesn't really matter what it is. I can make use of it in ProcessBook. For example, I can do an ad hoc trend by selecting it, clicking, and just building an ad hoc trend. Or I could any element, really, a trend, bar graph, a value, and I can make reference to it normally where I would do a tag search. I'll go out and choose AF, and I'm going to specify this is Tank A. We're looking for the attribute called level. And so we've made the same reference now. And that, of course, can be done with any of these dynamic elements.